Welcome to Filmora Pro, a new way to power up your storytelling. Today we'll be covering how you can key out backgrounds when working with black backdrops as well as green screens. We recently went over some compositing tips in our Compositing 101 video where we covered layering footage with blend modes, overlaying flares, and warping footage. In today's video we'll be covering different topics, but we definitely recommend you also check the first one out. Link in the description. When compositing in stock elements like fire or smoke, it can be useful to use a blend mode like darken or screen. However, sometimes blend modes won't give you the look you're looking for. For example, I've got this explosion clip that I want to composite into the shot, but I want to remove the black background from this clip. Now we could set this clip to screen or add, and it will remove the black in the backdrop, but our smoke won't really darken the background anymore. We really just want to get rid of the black itself in the video. So to do this, we can drag the luminance key effect from our effects panel into our clip. Let's make sure that it's set to key out darker and adjust our threshold. The higher the threshold, the more shadow values we'll remove. What you will notice, however, is that we'll get some really sharp lines around the edges of these dark smoke clouds. To help taper this off a bit, we can increase our tolerance, but keep it low enough so that we don't see any black background coming back. We'll tweak both until we're happy with how it looks. And there we go. Now we're free to composite our image into our shot. Let's take our explosion layer and position it right on this mountain and scale it down a bit while holding shift to keep our image proportional. Let's scrub to the beginning here just to position it right. There we go. Next, let's add a subtle blur so that it doesn't look too sharp. We'll drag in our blur effect and set it to about 2 pixels. That looks all right, but I want to feel more like there's some bright light coming off this explosion. Let's drag our playhead to the start of our clip, copy it, paste it, and select Create New Tracks. For this new explosion clip, let's go to our clip properties and change the blend mode to Add. Next, so that we're not brightening our smoke area, let's increase our threshold and tolerance quite a bit, say to around 70. Finally, let's go down to our blur and increase it to about 40. This will give our brighter areas of the explosion a bit of a glow effect. If we really want to liven it up, we can go to New Plane and create a black plane. We'll make sure it's the same size as our timeline, and then we'll drag it on top of our other clips. Let's also set it to Add and add a light flares effect. Next, let's drag our flare on top of where the explosion begins and change it to something more appropriate like anamorphic streak. We'll open the global heading and change our color to a nice light orange. To really sell this, we'll need to animate the intensity of the effect. Let's click the Display Timeline button up here if it isn't toggled already. Drag our playhead to just before when the explosion appears. And click this circle beside intensity to enable keyframing. Next, let's go back a bit and drag our intensity to 0. We'll go about a second after our original keyframe and also bring our intensity to 0. Now we'll have a nice dramatic flare to sell this explosion. Is it a volcanic eruption or a random explosion in the distance? You decide. You can learn more about keyframing in our Animation 101 tutorial. Link in the description. Chroma keying is the process of removing a certain color from your clip, like a green screen or a blue screen. The easiest way to start working with green screens in Filmora Pro is to go down to the effects panel and under presets, drag the green screen key onto your clip. If we go up to our controls panel, we'll now see that there are several effects on our clip. We've got the Chroma UV blur, the color difference key, a matte cleaner, and a spill removal. You can also find all these effects individually in the effects panel. So let's go over what all these effects do. When shooting a lot of green screen footage, you may run into noise around the edges caused by compression artifacting. The Chroma UV blur effect goes before all of the other green screen effects because it blurs the color values in your image to help smooth out that compression. The result is a smoother matte when keying out your green screen footage. I'm going to preemptively bring mine up to about 14 pixels, since this footage is a little compressed. The color difference key is the effect doing most of the work here. It's the effect that finds the green in your footage and keys it out. You can fine-tune your chroma key by adjusting the minimum, maximum, and gamma values down here. A really useful tool when fine-tuning your chroma key is the View Matte option, which you can toggle by checking this box here. In this view, everything that's white in the footage is being kept, and everything that's black in the footage is being removed from the clip. I'm seeing a ton of noise in the background. A way I've found that works well to fix our key in this clip is to adjust the gamma down like this. The matte cleaner comes after your color difference key and is a way to help clean up your matte if you're finding it too sharp, bumpy, or if you have too much green still showing on the edges. In this case, I'll bring up the feather to soften our edges a bit. Finally, we have the spill removal, which is a great way to remove the last of our green edging. Instead of cutting out any extra green, the spill removal will take those green areas and remove the green color from them. If you set it really high though, you might see it affect other colors like this bright yellow shirt, so we're actually going to dial it down a bit. Now that I'm happy with our chroma key, let's put a backdrop behind our subject. I've got this out of focus clip, which I'll drag onto the timeline underneath our green screen clip. And there we go! So that's a look at a couple different ways you can key out your footage, whether it be via brightness levels or specific colors like green screen footage. Make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on more tutorials on how you can take your editing to the next level. There is no limit to what you can make.